I moved to town to be a songwriter before I even became an artist, and I've always cared so much about writing songs and writing songs for other people, and I just have, I've been bitten by that bug, and it'll never go away no matter how, you know, much money I make or how well I do in the artist world. I'm always gonna write songs for other people, and I'm just trying to do something different and kind of carve my own path just with the rock and roll thing and the way I write songs, and that's above all. I think that's how I, you know, want to be remembered, and somebody sees my exhibit or anything, I want people to know that I really just tried to do something a little bit different than everyone else in town. We just decided to write a story song. Hunter Phelps and I sort of came up with the idea. He's another really big songwriter in town. He's had a really good few years. We just kind of were talking about, like, you know, if we ever found out that a guy had gotten, you know, physical or, you know, with one of our wives, like, what would we do? And I basically said, I think I would just find out where he lives and take Callie, my wife, take her with me and tell her to wait in the truck. And we kind of looked at each other and grinned, and we knew, we were like, oh, that's a good song idea. He's an angel, 'cause angels don't do what he did. So I wrote it down, and I would say 6 or 8 months went by without writing the song, and we even threw it out to some people, other artists and stuff, and we just never wrote it. And then we got a write with Jordan Schmidt, Hunter Phelps, and myself, and we threw that idea out, and it just, like, at first we thought about making it like this tough guy, and like, this guy roughed a girl up at a bar, and I'm gonna follow him home and like kick his ass, but we thought it'd be cooler to really dig into a story and create our own kind of universe and storyline, and it really just wrote itself that day. I mean, it was really cool, and we got to the chorus, and we were like, well, what if it was a duet, and what if the girl just comes in with her completely different perspective, you know, and we got Jordan's wife, Renee Blair, to sing the female part for the vocal, but when it comes to asking Lainey, she perfectly encapsulates that character, and her voice is so authentic and so real. And she's also a really good friend. I never fall my day of justice, but come from a judge under a sea. You know, I just knew that she could convey that emotion, and she would become that character probably more than anyone else in town. I knew that if she did a vocal that you could believe, then people would resonate with that more. It would, you know, it would help people more. So I fired away. I said, hey, I got one of the best songs I've ever written, and I would love for you to be a part of it. And she said, yeah. 60 months, and she still comes to see me from time to time. It was worth the price to see a brighter side of the girl I picked up that night. And I might be here forever.